Good morning, guys. Well, I guess it's afternoon now. Good afternoon. How is everyone? Well, we've got a couple more people coming in. We're missing a few. How is everybody? Everybody there? Behind their computers? Awesome. Well, as you were coming in, I was playing last year's slideshow from our FFA chapter. So hopefully you got to see some of the cool stuff that we've done. Maybe there's a few of you that have been in here before, so maybe you caught a glimpse of yourself. So welcome, my name is Meredith Wolf. I'm the Agricultural and Environmental Technologies teacher at Clay. It is my fifth year at Clay, my 11th year teaching. And I was actually a Clay Eagle when I was in high school as well, so it's kind of cool. And my goals for today, guys, are just to talk to you about our program, if you aren't super familiar with it. So talk to you about our program, as well as, entertain any questions that you might have, and then definitely go take like a little tour of our lab, and we can show you some of the animals that are currently here, although some of them, most of them, are at home with students from over the break. So like I said, this is Agricultural and Environmental Technologies. It's actually a four-year program. There is a freshman and sophomore course. You can jump in your junior year, and we'll get you up to speed, but it is a two-period class. So if you're thinking about your schedule, it's two periods. This year, it's seventh and eighth period. There's no guarantee it'll be seventh and eighth period next year, but it's two periods. And the way I set my class up is that one period is a classroom lesson. It's a classroom lesson. We cover some sort of content. So next year, our content is going to be environmental systems. So we're going to talk about air and soil and water and wildlife, do a lot of natural resources. And then the following year is greenhouse and nursery management. And so we'll cover that in our classroom activities. And you're like, hey, wait a minute, you said you have animals too. And yeah, so your second period then is your lab period or your committee period. And agriculture is just such a huge topic, right? I want, Gwyneth might be interested in one thing, Isabella's interested in another one, and Kimberly's interested in something completely different, but they're all under the scope of agriculture. Agriculture includes food science, business, natural resources, plant science, animal science. It's very broad. So that lab period or the committee period is really a time for you to get to decide what you want to focus on. Are you really interested in animals? You can take care of some of our animals, maybe do a research project on some of our animals. Are you really interested in fish and raising fish? Or are you really interested in plants? Maybe you can be the caretaker in our greenhouse. So that period is really a lab period where you get to decide what you want to focus on. And we can talk about that a little as I take you through the lab. A couple things that I do want to remember to tell you before we get distracted out in the lab is that you are involved in a CTSO, a student organization. And the student organization that you're involved in is the FFA. And the National FFA organization is the biggest student organization in the country, which is awesome. There are 23 different contests that we can compete in the state of Ohio. Anything from nursery and landscaping competition to food science to animal management, where you have to identify dog breeds and species of birds, and you have to prove that you can tell the care requirements for different kinds of animals, all sorts of things, all the way to like public speaking. So we have a lot of different competitions for you to get involved in, and I can show you some of our awards. We get district and state awards, lots of really good stuff to put on your resume and pad your resume for when you're applying for those scholarships and for those jobs and for college. Show colleges that you're really serious. There are leadership opportunities. You can be part of our officer team. Community service opportunities. We do community service, as well as different events like kayaking in the fall. We do clean your streams in the fall. We go out and clean up a waterway. I already said awards, and we travel a lot. Gwyneth will tell you, we're back and forth to Columbus all the time. We take a lot of field trips, and I've taken kids to Indianapolis. I've taken kids to Massachusetts for different contests. So if you're someone who likes to travel, maybe you'll have some interest in that. Also, I just wanted to mention one of the perks of being in ag is that there is some CCP credit involved when you get to the senior year. So some CCP credit, as well as some articulated credit with Hocking College, which is down by Hocking Hills, as well as Clark State. So there are some college credit benefits to being in the ag program. Any questions before we get started out in the lab? Has anybody ever been in the ag building before? I know Gwyneth has. All right, well, we'll get started here. So my building is down the hallway with MedTech and cosmetology and culinary. And we have a whole building so you get to do fun stuff with. One part that you could be in charge of for your committee period is our aquaculture tanks. So as a member of the junior senior class, if you were, if you requested to be part of the junior senior program or the aquaculture committee, you would be able to get to decide what we raise in these tanks, how you want to stock them. You make all the management decisions for the aquaculture tanks. So you'd be in charge of feeding the fish, taking daily measurements. Our bass wants to say hello. See the bass. So aquaculture is really becoming pretty popular because we have a lot of people to feed in the universe, right, on Earth. And you can produce fish pretty efficiently in these tanks. So you get to decide what you want to raise. I think, I don't know if you can see them, but there's perch in here. And so our students that take care of these take daily water checks, checking the oxygen and the nitrates and the ammonia levels. We also have several different aquariums. You'd be in charge of the more of the tropical fish. We have got some tetras and an Oscar and some guppies this year. We kind of scaled back because of nobody's here to help me clean out tanks. Another big trend in our industry is hydroponics. So if you see these grow towers, we've got some lettuce. There's some dill and some basil growing. We're starting to work pretty closely with culinary in order to grow some herbs and some lettuce and things for them to use like in their salads and things that they cook. So Hydroponics is becoming really popular. Hydroponics is just the method of growing plants without any soil. So it's pretty popular in urban settings where there's not a whole field to grow some lettuce. We don't have land to grow the crops. We just need somewhere vertical to grow them instead. So you could be in charge of growing plants. And as I mentioned, we do have a contest called the AgriScience Fair contest, and you do some form of experiment related to agriculture. So, you know, we have all this equipment and all these animals, not just because it's fun to try to grow something or it's awesome to have animals, but also to try to do some educational projects and come up with some research on those animals and those plants. So one of the contests that we get to do and that we usually do pretty well in is the wildlife management contest. You identify mammals by their pelt or by their skull or maybe by a picture of them. We've got some soil test kits. We cover soil in class. So a lot of people see the animals and think it's only animals, but we cover a wide variety of topics, including things like soil and water. And back here, did you see this? Can you see this? This is a bar from our beehive. We actually have a beehive now. We earned a grant to have a beehive. So it's a bar from our beehive. And I don't know if you saw it when I was back by the door, but we have waders and seines and nets and things. As the junior senior program, we always do the student watershed watch and hike over to the Oregon Rec and do water quality testing. So you get to hop in the stream and test the waters if you're into adventuring. My classroom, I'll just show you around real quick. Taxidermy is one of the parts that we do. We have a local taxidermist that comes in and helps out a lot. That was a former student a long time ago. So these are all student done mounts. And we keep them around again because students have to identify different species of birds and mammals and things in the wildlife contest. So this helps us study. And our axolotl hasn't been out today, or I'd show you our axolotl. He's hiding today. So we've got an axolotl. We bring animals into the classroom. Our bird stand is here. If anybody has any questions, I don't want to talk the whole time. I'm not into teaching by like a PowerPoint, so I don't have a PowerPoint for you. I just wanted to show you kind of the different aspects that we have in class. At the beginning of class, or at the beginning of school this year, we hatched some chickens. Do you guys want to see one of the chickens? We hatched some chickens, so we had an incubator, and some of our chickens from last year were laying eggs, so we were able to grab some of their fertile eggs and watch the chicks grow inside of the eggs, which was fun. He doesn't want to be caught. So as a junior or senior in our program, these guys will start laying eggs here shortly. And again, we work with culinary and supply a lot of their eggs, which is kind of a cool crossover, a cool collaboration. So another part that you could be involved in is our reptiles. So we've got a turtle pond. We were given some turtles by the ODNR, red ear sliders by the ODNR, due to the fact that red ear sliders are invasive in Ohio, and they don't want them in the wild because they are damaging to the native species. One of the other projects that we have going on, which I think is one of the cooler projects, I don't know if you can see them all that well, but these are quail, which are a tiny little bird that is actually native to Northwest Ohio. And in the snowstorm of 1978, they were decimated because they mostly live on the ground in low-lying shrubs. And so we hatched some, we've been hatching some and working with local landowners to release them on their property.
so that we could hopefully get the populations back up. So you could be involved in hatching some of those and seeing what comes out of the incubator.
Another aspect of our program is our mammals. We have a couple of rabbits, a chinchilla, a couple of guinea pigs. We have mice. We have mice because we also have reptiles, so they work kind of hand in hand with each other. And then also we have mice because they're an easy topic to do for agri-science fair projects. Let me show you one of our babies. They had babies over the summer, or not over the summer, over the winter break. So you could be in charge of taking care of our mice. Do you guys want to see the guinea pigs? The guinea pigs are here. Anybody there? Of course. All right, hold on. Let me grab one of them. Let's see if they can, they're catchable. He didn't want to be catchable, but he was caught catchable. So this is Elvis. The other one's Presley. So we have some different animals, and we don't just have animals to have animals and learn how to take care of them. We do have them to learn how to take care of them, but also because these are in the animal management contest. So you have to identify the different breeds of guinea pigs and be able to talk to a judge about how to tell if it's a boy or a girl, how you're supposed to handle them, how to do a checkup on them, different things like that. So we have them for a reason. And they're cute. So an extra bonus of being in ag is that you can sign up to take animals home for over Christmas break or spring break, which is a good perk. Those are our guinea pigs. Let's see what else we've got. Is this session over? Do you know? We've got our floral fridge here. We don't have any flowers in it right now, but on a normal year, we do some floral design projects. Like right around homecoming, we have the homecoming corsage and boutonniere sale. Thanks, Gwyneth. We do Valentine's Day bud vases. This past year, we did like an arrangement of the month. So you could be in charge, you know, if that strikes your interest, you could be in charge of working with that. I'm going to go show you the greenhouse here. This is our greenhouse. So we work with a lot with propagation and reproducing the plants that are out here. There's a lot of plants out here that have also been like the product of some agri-science fair projects. And they are available to you for agri-science fair projects. We also work with Mommy Bay, the naturalist at Mommy Bay. Every year we take a field trip with our junior senior class to go out and collect native seeds like milkweed, boneset, gray coneflower, different plants that are native to here that we want to grow here that are good for native insects, native pollinators, native wildlife. And we grow them in our greenhouse in order to take them out in the spring and plant them at Mommy Bay. This year, I'm really excited. We've got like a partnership going on with the Toledo Zoo to go out to the elementary schools and plant some of our natives at their prairie projects. So if any of you have like little brothers or sisters are aware of the prairie projects at the elementary schools. That door is creaking. We have a sulcata tortoise. He's out sunning himself right now. I'll grab him. We have a sulcata tortoise. We have two sulcata tortoises. Georgia is our biggest. So she's in the reptile committee. She gets taken care of by the reptile committee. Ooh. And we actually have an additional classroom in our program, and we refer to it as the resource room. Here's Purdy, Purdy Birdie. She's a Conyer. She's one of our residents here. And so we work with a avian vet to take care of our birds. And oftentimes she gets us some rescues that come in so that we can work with them. We collect milkweed in the fall, which is a type of plant that only monarch butterflies will eat. It's the only plant that they'll eat. So while we're collecting milkweed, oftentimes we find some monarch caterpillars or chrysalis. So we will hatch them out and watch them. We have an incubator so we can hatch out some chicken eggs or quail eggs and repopulate. And it's always fun, whoever is working with the incubator, to see what pops out of there. Also available for agri-science fair projects. We have a brooder where the chicks go when they're first hatched to keep warm. Let's see if you can see this guy. There's an immature quail. He'd get picked on if we threw him in with the adults out in the greenhouse. We've got some lovebirds that are in the avian committee. I don't know if you can see this guy. This is a Zool. He's a blue-tongued skink. So he's in our reptile committee. And a lot of our reptiles aren't back. We've got a ball python. We've got some leopard geckos, a bearded dragon, a corn snake. And we've also recently tried to get kind of like an insect committee going with some hissing cockroaches and tarantula and things like that, if you're interested in insects. So we've got a couple minutes left. Are there any questions? Like what we do in ag, what the class is like, any concerns you want cleared up? No? Well, I would be happy to answer any questions that you have. Either you can ask them here or feel free to email me. My email address is mwolf@OregonCitySchools. I can put it in the chat for you. And I would be happy to answer any questions that you have. I'm really excited that you joined us today to see our program. And I look forward to hopefully seeing you next year in the program. This is a reminder that at the end of our day today, you are going to be emailed a survey or an application asking you about your top choices to continue with career in tech. So they're asking you that even if you decide that you no longer want to take any kind of career in tech, that you still fill that out so they know your intentions for the counselor. So make sure you, I didn't push enter on that. Make sure that you watch for an email to tell you to apply to a program. If there are no more questions, if there's no questions, I would love to answer any questions that you have, but if there are none, you can go ahead and get ready for your next session. The next session starts at 1:30. Thanks for joining. Bye, Gwyneth.